Hello everyone. So we can now reveal to you Potter Peg, the game. Yesterday evening I did a test run online with my co-developer and it worked really well. So pay attention and let us explain the rules to you. So what you are going to need to do is get your masking tape and then map out or mark out your pitch. So you will see here we have marked out just our throwing line, and then if we pan across up there we have, and this is 2 meters, so 2 meters we're doing the isolation. This is where you're going to place your pot. Now, because of testing, we discovered that the pot should be about, now I'm having to use this, okay? Now this is 12 centimeters across, okay? So you want a pot that is about 12 centimeters in width. Depth perhaps doesn't matter too much, but a normal plant pot size would probably be about that anyway. So you place your pot on the marker, and then you head back to the throwing point. You get yourself your peg. Now I've had to put some sellotape on, but that doesn't matter too much as long as it kind of doesn't fall apart when you throw it. So the object of the game is as follows. The object of the game is player one gets their peg and attempts to throw the peg into the pot like this. Let's see if we can do it. So, okay, I missed. So that's player one. Then player two takes their turn. And now if player two gets their peg in the pot, that means they get a point because they have stolen that end from player one. So let's have a go and see if we can do it. No, that was pretty rubbish. So that means that's the end of round one. So then it's on to player one again, and then the game continues. Now, if player one gets their peg in just like that, that means player two now has to get their peg into the pot to be able to equalize. And that means there's no points for either player. But let's try. If we try and see if we can get it in. So I've missed. So that now means that player two has lost the point. So player one, because they got their peg in the bucket, that means they have gained the point because player two missed. And so then the next round, player one continues to throw. If, however, player one missed and player two got their peg into the pot, that means player two has stolen the round, and that means they get 1 point, but they then become player, the first person to throw. So you're kind of switching depending on if you gain a point. And the idea is you keep doing it that way until a player reaches 5 or 10 points. And that really is it. And that basically is the game. So you take it in turns, player one goes, if they get it in the pot, then player two takes their turn, and if they get it in the pot, no points. If player one gets it, their peg in the pot, but player two does not get their peg in the pot, that means player one wins the point. If player one misses the pot, but player two gets the peg in the pot, that means player two gets the point, and then they become the first person to throw. And if the game continues that way. And that is Potter Peg. Have a go. Tell us what you think. If you enjoy it, let us know. All the rules will be on www.sketchesintravel.com. Thank you ever so much. Have fun playing Potter Pig.